by your Princess Silke. And when I lived in Robin Hood Drive, number 23. Yeah, Robin Hood, like Robin Hood, number 23. I had a large garden. To me, it was large. For my standards as princess, it's just nothing. Nothing. Say it? Not even my hortalisa will fit in there. Oh, goodness. I'm crying. I'm touched. No one ever cared for me before. No one ever cared for me. So, yeah, he said, you want a garden, you have to take care of it. That's what he said. Can you believe it? He had a tiny one in San Francisco. Yeah, his ex attended that one. I guess. I'm not sure. At least she planted the stuff. I don't know. I just got the feeling about it. And no, Yaki didn't like the outdoors. I mean, imagine, he did not. Who doesn't like the outdoors? Huh? Wow, tremendous. So I had a garden. And of course, I need a garden, man. I need a garden. To me, it was large. And I planted it from scratch, man. Because I took all the hedges out, which were two. At the. Huh? Adjacent wall to what? An L shape that was a hedge. I took it out. And then there was a rose garden, which wasn't nice. I took it out. Then there was stinky flowers. Margaritas? Not sure, but the stinky ones. I took them out. Again. Yeah, of course. I mean, I am homey, man. That's what I am. Taurus, right? I work like shit crazy because I need my home. That's what I need, my home. So I do anything to establish a home. So I get up earlier than anybody. I drive earlier than anybody. I start painting, cleaning, all sorts of things I did. Yes, I went up to start painting at 6 a.m. to be ready. I don't know, I'm just that person. I need my home. So once the move would be done and the boxes would stay, I would prepare a tiny spot to feel home. Because I don't like the chaos. I work just because I need the chaos off. I need my home. So I put a little, there was a little table. I had a little table and I put flowers on, which I picked from the garden for a little snack, for a little lunch. I mean the work, but I make a space homey, just like that. And as we were eating, I don't know, maybe sandwich. I was smelling weird. What is this? Smell, smell. And I noticed the flowers stink like shit. Literally, like poop, man. I heard later that Burbank Park in Santa Rosa, that was the Burbank person who put flowers together and make new species, and that he wasn't quite finished with this one yet. They were very tall. I think they were like margaritas, white ones. Well, disgusting. Of course, I did not keep them. I took them all out, man. And yeah, that was that. That's what I took out. And later, I did the front. The front yard had a few bushes, but first I did the backyard. I did it by scratch, but then when the garden was pretty much done, I took care of it all the time. I never ever had a gardener, not once. And first we had a large lawnmower. That was Yaki's, and he would not mow the lawn, man. That was such a man hassle, 3 weeks, 6 weeks procrastination for any little project, being a contractor and such. So eventually I changed it. I threw that one out and I bought a new one, a tiny one. Yeah, handling easy and lightweight and also electric with batteries to be rechargeable. I established the shed. The shed was there, but it was a mess. So since I painted so very many walls and different colors, I had all the rest. So I painted the shed. And then I installed all these things which I had been learning from Yagi from San Francisco, that you can actually have stuff where you can install and put your tools on the wall. I did not know anything about it. Not from Germany and not from Mexico. So I did those things. I put it all up by myself. Yeah, man, hammers and nails and all this, and drills and paints and brushes and all of it. No, the fence I did later. I don't know, I had to look. It's like, I'm like this. I look and I look and I look some more, and if there's something needs to be established or changed or arranged or fixed or planted or re-emplaced, I do it. So I do one and another, step. And when I had the garden planted, then I looked at the fence and that looks ugly. And he had told me, like, you know, that can't be painted. It's wood, man. Why wouldn't it? So then, as I insisted, he reluctantly said, well, there is this machine. And that's a little machine which sands the wall. Oh God, you have a sanding machine. Oh my God, he had so many tools. He never showed me the shit. He never showed me anything. Because then he was out. So here I was sanding the walls and then painting them. It's hard work, and it was a very large fence. I almost finished. I don't know why I couldn't finish the entire, because I usually don't leave things pending. Maybe just for anybody to see it at the end. Yeah, but I would get up. And well, then everybody was out of the house. So I would, of course, take off my shoes because I'm a bare feet girl. I really like it so much. Yeah, well, my feet, see, sometimes I get a little bit mistreated out there, but I like bare feet so very much, indoors, outdoors. So I would go barefoot outdoors and I would now mow my lawn. Yes, in the sunshine, and I would be grateful. And then, of course, I had to learn. I had to look around. I had to look at the gardeners around. They had blowers. Oh my God, you don't need to sweep the leaves. You can blow them. Wow, and you don't need to chop with the little, with the little clippers. The bushes, you can actually saw them away. Oh my goodness. So I got all the tools, all matching, all electric. Yeah, I know, one we picked up at Richard's house, at Jackie's father. I don't know, I was laying on the floor and no one would use it because I had nothing to chop. That was one large saw from the same brand, which was good because the same batteries would fit. So, and I would take care of it. I would mow the lawn. I did not pick up the grass. I made these choices. I think I left it even since Cuernavaca. Because why would you pick them up? I mean, you pick them up. Okay, wait, the lawnmower maybe picks it up. I have to think about it. With the bags on the lawnmower. Then where do you put it to compost it somewhere? I think I would just leave it out there, laying there. And then again, I might be mistaken. I'm seriously not sure about it right now. Because it wouldn't be that large. I think I just left it laying there to, you know, to mulch or so. But I would then take the blower. I would blow the terrace on the passageways and also in the front. In the front, there was a tiny piece of lawn. I was not reluctant to do it, but I figured that the people around me would be judgmental, particularly my Mexican neighbor in front, that I would do that over myself. But never mind, just what I did. I would cut the shrubs, I would plant, I would do on and on and on, would I do work. And as soon as I could, I would enhance and I would do a vegetable garden, a small one. I would start with a little bit of this and that. Yeah, not really buy seeds, I would buy the plants, the tiny ones. Yeah, and of course I would involve those who had to learn about it too, at least once. So you know how stuff works. So that's what I would be doing. And I like that I can take care of my things. Not that I want to do the garden work. I mean, I have so much to do and I can do so many very different things. But I don't mind because I like my nice things nice, my home, homey and cozy and warm. Incarnated, I'm a stargazing. Life goes on, honey, and all my babies. Woke up looking for the broccoli. High key, keep a horn on me. Deck of my seat. IP, ownership, the blueprint is by me. Mr. Get Off, I get off at my feet.